this is not the ultimate state management in Flutter. It's a clickbait. I'm sorry, I couldn't resist. This is my debut on YouTube and, you know, I just had to do it. So feel free to downvote. And let's dive in. So the famous architecture I was talking about, I call it sprinkle architecture. And it's basically just the block pattern disguised. But we are adding some things, so I figured, how about using some funny name? And this is it, sprinkle architecture. I hope you won't forget how it works. But before we go into how it works, let me just recite this poem, or rather song, because I think it's cool that this pattern, this architecture has a song associated with it. So, sprinkle, sprinkle, little rose, this is how my garden grows. Just add water here and there, you will see roses everywhere. Okay, so imagine that you have a garden, like a big garden, beautiful garden, and there are plants like flowers and trees and other stuff, but you also have some things to arrange your garden, like benches, like rocks, maybe sculptures. So they are used to make it prettier, but at the same time, they are static compared to flowers, compared to your plants, because your plants, they grow, they change, and you have to manage them. While benches or rocks, they are pretty, they help you arrange like sections of your garden, but they are always the same. So like a big, big garden. And let's say that we have those people, managers, and they are responsible for managing a section of your garden. Because your garden is so big that you have to divide this garden into sections. And each section has a person who's responsible for managing it. And we will call that person manager. And then, on top of that, you will have one person, and we will call that overseer, who supervises managers. Because there are so many managers in this garden that we need one person who will manage everything. And on top of that, managers mainly use sprinklers. So you use water streams to irrigate your plants, to add water to your plants. And sprinklers produce water streams for the plants. So this is the architecture we are talking about. And of course, the garden is the metaphor for the application. So we have the application on the left side, and we have, parallel to that, we have overseer who manages managers. And managers, they manage streams, which are used by our widgets, and they also observe things. So this is pretty creepy, this sign, this eye, but the idea is that managers cannot not only provide streams to widgets, but widgets can do something which can be observed by managers. And this is the equivalent of a sink. So this eye represents a sink. So it's something that the managers receive the data they gather from widgets, and then they may do something with that. Like in the relation to the stream state they manage or not, it depends. And it's using the stream state push data towards the widgets. And we have two types of widgets. As I said, they are widgets such as like benches and sculptures and rocks in garden, like containers and all that. So the widgets that are used to arrange things, but they don't need water because they are static. And there are other widgets like plants, which they need water to evolve, to change. So that's basically it. And as you can see here at the top, we are wrapping our application with the overseer. So that's the reason I was talking about immutable inherited widget, because we will wrap the whole application, and the only dependency we will add to the tree, to the widget tree, is an instance of overseer. And then each widget will be able to ask the overseer for a manager, and then for a specific stream that widget is interested in. So we are just passing the overseer, and then based on that, every widget is able to find the proper information, the proper stream through that. So you may ask, if you have just one instance of the overseer and you are passing this to the application, why not using globals? Because you can define this as a global and use it the same way. So the answer is simple in the sense that, so there is like a slight advantage of passing the overseer through the widget tree using an immutable inherited widget compared to declaring it as a global, which is testing. So if we pass it like that, we can then, when testing our application, we can easily replace the overseer with a mock of it and pass it down the widget tree, which would be slightly more complicated if we declared this dependency as a global. So that's the only reason. And because we are passing just one instance, it just simplifies everything. Another point is that the overseer, in fact, is an implementation of a pattern called service locator. So it's a pattern that allows you to ask for some other dependencies, and you have just widgets only depend on overseer, and overseer is able to provide the dependencies they are interested in behind the scenes, so they don't have to worry about that. And that's what we will explore in this application. So when I was thinking about this architecture and how to present it in a digestible way so you could remember and you know exactly what we are trying to achieve here, I had this reflection that it's somehow similar to JavaScript landscape. And in JavaScript, you have many state management solutions, but there are two which are pretty well known. And the first one is Redux, which I'm not a fan of, but Redux is relatively simple a solution to the state management, but it's not easy. So it's a very small library, which causes a lot of problems to people to understand how it works and what's the idea, what's the essential idea. And what's interesting about Redux is that you are doing the state management manually. There is a lot of things that you have to manually do stuff, and I think that's the source of confusion maybe. That's Redux. And then there is another thing which I like. It's called mobx, and mobx uses observables, which are streams, to do exactly the same thing, to manage the state. There are some differences, but the most important one is that Redux is a solution that solves the problems that you will probably never encounter. It's a solution that is made for scale. If you are doing the next Facebook or like a very big application, which is rare, you will have certain problems, and the way it's resolved in Redux may be beneficial in that case, but for the most people, it's not needed. Even if you encounter one of those problems that Redux tries to address, you could just solve it, you know, in an old way, because it will be rare, and the amount of things you have to consider just to create this architecture using Redux is, there are a lot of trade-offs with that. So Redux reminds me a little bit of inherited widget in its mutable form, or scoped model, or any other solution that somehow based on this idea that you have to manage things manually. You have to think about them. Should I, for example, pass true or false to update? Should notify? Should I use this method to access the inherited widget to subscribe it to the changes, or should I not subscribe it to the changes? So there's a lot of thinking and a lot of decisions on your side. The things that are, let's say, manual that you have to do. And so inherited widget, mutable inherited widget, this library called provider or scoped model, for me, they are somehow similar to Redux. So you have to do the stuff manually. While mobx, it's more automatic. It just uses streams as the same way as we are using a stream builder, and we have streams in Dart. Mobx uses observables, and it's just everything is somehow made behind the scenes. So you don't have to worry about this. You just take a stream or an observable and you use it. That's a kind of like analogy. Maybe it's just me, but I was thinking that maybe it could be useful for you if you are already using JavaScript to compare it with what we are trying to achieve here. Mobx is practical. You just declare your state, those observables, and then you just use it. So people find it easier to start using it. And the block pattern introduced by Google is somehow similar to what people are doing with mobx. And with this sprinkle architecture, we are just adding very small layer of a service locator, which allows us to manage our dependencies, widgets dependencies. It's slightly easier to manage them like that. So to finish off the sprinkle architecture and this awful clickbait, let me just recite another poem I created. And it goes like that. Sprinkle, sprinkle, little widget. This is how my UI changes. Just add stream or sync here and there. You will have beautiful state management everywhere. Okay, that was cringy and pretty dry, so I think I will remove that. Yeah. See you next time.